If you want to find out if Florensia is still playable in 2021, follow me in this adventure to the end of the video, because I will be dissecting all kinds of things about the game, and you will know for sure if it is worth your time. Hello gamers, and welcome back to another episode where I check a game to see if it is worth playing or not. In today's episode, our guest is Florensia Online. Let's see how things went and begin the journey. But before you do that, you can feed the algorithm beast with a like, if you are kind enough. Okay, so let's start with the bread and butter of any game, and the things you want to see the most, and that is the gameplay mechanics. Florensia has top targeted combat, but it felt fluid and not laggy at all. You can switch between two weapons and you have some common skills for each weapon type for whatever class you pick. In my case, I went with a mercenary and focused on the sword and shield. The game gives you attribute points to put on every level, and so you can make a build. I focused mainly on strength and constitution for high numbers on le damage and big health. Also, a little bit of luck for some crit chance. What got me really annoyed was the thing that when I kill the monster, it will throw it away from me, and I ended it with a critical strike, it will be thrown away even further. Imagine that I had to walk again to loot all the monsters I killed, and that I think it is really dumb and saw no purpose in it. I mean, if someone or something is stabbed to death or cut, it will not jump backwards 5 meters away from the killer. What the fuck, am I right? Anyway, let's talk a little about the skills. Florensia didn't give me a lot of skills to choose from, and I played to almost level 20. I mean, I had some passives and two branches of skills, but because I focused on one weapon type and I had to max those out, I was left with pretty few active abilities. Maybe at endgame, when you have more skill points to put into and you can create a mix of those two weapon types, you'll have plenty more. But even then, it's tricky, because as so you'll have to choose a specialization based on what weapon you want to use. So, the combat felt a little boring being top targeted and having 4 skills or something like that. The game has a unique feature that you don't really see in any MMORPG, not even in many games per total. You have naval combat, where you will buy a type of ship, customize it, buy skills, ammo type, and recruiting crew. I was really surprised when I saw this feature for the first time, but got disappointed really quick. The naval combat works like this. You press W, you will set sail. You press S, you will launch around the place, after the meter for sailing or staying in a point reaches whatever you want to do. You shoot with your cannons from the sides and front, and you have some harpoons, so you can fight enemies when they approach you too much. Your skills are either range attacks or close attacks and some passives, but I played a little bit on the sea, and I don't really know what you will be able to obtain at higher levels, because the game has a system that you have land levels and sea levels, so do quests according to what aspect of the game you want to grow. I didn't really feel the sea combat that engaging, and a little bit slow and boring. In my opinion, this is a wasted feature, but maybe it was a blast back in the day when the game was launched. In the end, the combat of Florensia is nothing special, at least it's not laggy, but I have a problem with the naval gameplay. Let's talk about the classes and character customization. The game has 4 classes, mercenary, explorer, noble, and saint. They are warrior, shooter, mage, and priest. And all of them are able to use 2 different weapons and have 2 different paths that they can choose later in the game. Depends on what you want to focus. Florensia Online doesn't have the most compelling character creation system. It's really basic, with some faces to change, some hairstyles and hair color, and that's all. But it was expected, because you couldn't really find games back in the day with an in-depth customization for your avatar, besides Perfect World. Let's see the story of the game. Well, the game doesn't have any particular story, with no cutscenes, whatsoever. Maybe you can find one if you stay and read the quests, but I know you don't have time for that. Let's talk about my questing experience. My experience with the missions of this game were pretty basic. Like in most MMORPGs, kill X amount of stuff and collect blood samples and empty bottles. What is funny is that the game is having you kill a mushroom, then a giant mushroom, then a fierce mushroom, and then maybe some lord mushroom or something like that. The monsters in this game are redesigned with a lot of different colors and names, or maybe they are just smaller or bigger, but with all that in mind, it didn't really felt too repetitive and I didn't got bored of them. Some of the collecting missions in this game are a real hassle, because you will have to collect maybe 8 pieces of something and it has a small chance to drop. You'll find one from maybe 10 mobs, or not, or sometimes faster, but in the big picture, it is a grind quest and you will have to kill a lot of the same monsters. Also, what I disliked is that you had to walk a lot in this game from NPC to NPC to the zones where you will do your quests, back in town, again from NPC to another NPC. It felt really tedious overall. Atmosphere of the here, I will start with the population because it was pretty low. I saw some high level players in the main city and I think two low level players, and that was the most populated server. In terms of the graphics, the game looks old school. This type of graphics were mentioned to be anime style back in the day. I'm really glad that games like Blue Protocol and Genshin Impact changed that, and now we have a lot of cool looking anime styles games coming up. The environment was pretty colorful and with a little bit of a childish feel to it. I saw only one type of zone, and that was something like a hill, and one side of the map had a little beach. So I can't say what the game has in store for endgame levels, but the graphic style would be the same, so they will feel a little repetitive in my opinion. The gear. Well, the items of the game looked really basic, even on endgame. The weapons can look a little bit flashy, but not enough for me. They felt really bland and boring. Florensia gives you the gift, but it doesn't throw at you overpowered items. Instead, it just gives you some fashion elements with a little boosting of stats, but nothing too crazy. It's good because like that I could hide my ugly armor set. Let's talk about the endgame. About the endgame, I can't really talk too much because I didn't find any forums to check them out. But from how I see the game system, I think it's mostly grinding dungeons. Another thing, I assume that there is some PvP elements to the game, because I saw some players with red names and that usually indicates that they are cruel and they PK a lot, I mean player killing. So like in any MMORPG, endgame consists in grind and PvP to some extent reported to this game. If you know otherwise, feel free to leave a commentary. Okay, thank you for keeping up with me until the end. We have one more section to cover, the pros and cons, but before we do that, support the channel with a like, because the algorithm beast is hungry for them. If you like the content, and if you want to follow me into my next adventures, join the legacy by using the subscribe spell. You can support me even further on Patreon. Also, if you want to check more games that I already covered, check my channel. And remember, I try games, so you don't have to waste your time. Pros and cons. What I liked about Florensia is that it felt really optimized. You can spec and build your character to your liking by adding attributes points and focusing on one talent. The game is old school anime and I was a fan of this game, so it's a pro. What I disliked about the game is that you have to walk so much and talk to NPCs. The gear look really bland even on high level players. The naval aspect of the game was so bad implemented and so boring that I played only like 5 levels on that. So overall, Florensia was a decent game, and I would recommend you to try it if you like old school anime games, and maybe if you find someone to play with, because the population is pretty low. If you want just to grind, I think you will get bored pretty fast. In the end, Florensia is worth a try. Irene approves. Thank you for watching, and see you on the next video. Have a grindy day, with plenty of good drops. See you soon.